Hello dear students, welcome back. Today we are going to start the new chapter, chapter number 2, Accounting for Debentures. Before we begin with the chapter, let's have a brief introduction about the chapter. Debentures are an important source of long-term and medium-term finance. Debenture holders are the lenders of the company. Debenture issued under the seal of the company is a written document of the acceptance of loan. Normally, the company issues shares for the requirement of long-term funds. Sometimes, in addition to share capital, if company requires more fund, then these funds can be met by loan or borrowed amount. Financially sound companies get long-term loan from bank or financial institutions. Mostly, instead of borrowing such loan from financial institutions or in addition to borrowing such loan for large investment, company can raise funds from public by issue of securities. Such a security is popularly known as debentures or bond. Now let us understand meaning of debenture. Debenture is an instrument issued under the common seal of the company acknowledging a debt and is a contract for the repayment of the principal sum at a specified date and for the payment of interest at a fixed rate per percent until the principal sum is repaid. Or we can say that debenture refers to the loan to the company by the debenture holders on which they receive a fixed rate of interest. The amount of loan can be divided into units of small denominations and the company can sell them to the public. Each unit is called a debenture and holder of such units is called debenture holder. The amount so raised is a loan for the company. Now let us discuss features or characteristics of debentures. First point is borrowed fund. Debentures are part of borrowed fund capital as debenture holders are considered as the creditors of the company. Second point, fixed rate of interest. Debenture is a security that bears a fixed rate of interest on which the interest is payable on a predetermined date. Company has to pay the interest on the debentures even if it has earned profit or not earned a profit. Interest on debentures is payable at a fixed rate and so debentures are known by that rate. Example, if interest is payable at the rate 8% per annum on debentures, then it is known as or written as 8% debentures. Then next is compulsory payment of interest. Payment of regular and fixed rate of interest is a legal obligation of the company. Company has to pay interest to its debenture holders irrespective of its profit earning capacity. And next point, security. Most of the time, debentures are issued against the charge of some fixed assets of the company. Debentures can be issued with or without charge on the assets of the company. Charge on the assets means mortgage or hypothecation. The next point, redeemable. Debentures are always redeemed or paid back on expiry of a fixed period of time. When debentures are issued for a fixed term, the money borrowed against such debentures is repaid at the end of a fixed term in accordance with the agreed terms. As per Companies Act 2013, no company is allowed to issue debentures having a maturity date of more than 10 years from the date of issue. However, a company engaged in infrastructure projects can issue debentures for more than 10 years but not exceeding 30 years. In the event of the liquidation of a company, the debenture holders are repaid their money before the payment to equity shareholders. Next point, no voting rights. Debenture holders have no say in the management as they are never granted voting rights in the company. Debenture holders do not have any voting right in any matter of the company. Next point, appointment of trustee. When a large number of debentures are sold to the general public, then usually a trustee is appointed. Trustee can be a bank or financial institution. The trustee is appointed to ensure that the borrowing firm fulfills its contractual obligations. Now let us see what is issue of debentures. By issuing debentures means issue of a certificate by the company under its seal, which is an acknowledgement of debt taken by the company. The procedure of issue of debentures by a company is similar to that of the issue of shares. A prospectus is issued, applications are invited, and letters of allotment are issued. On rejection of applications, application money is refunded. In case of partial allotment, excess application money may be adjusted towards subsequent calls. Debentures are shown as long-term borrowings under the heading non-current liabilities on equity and liabilities side in the balance sheet. Usually, debentures are listed on the stock exchange after the issue thereof, and purchase or sales of debentures are traded at the stock exchange. The market value of such debentures could be more or less than the price of the issue. If the terms of the issue of debentures so provide, the debentures can be converted into shares. Debentures cannot be forfeited if any debenture holder does not pay any amount on debentures. So, dear students, these were the important points of relating to debentures. I hope you would have understood this. Thank you very much.